I have my sketch and the building parts. Can move this in there. Very good. So with this, I can turn all this on and off. And then here is my one bottle, the other bottle. Here is the ring. This is also a building part. I move this to there. The last thing now actually to do is create the threading. The threading is actually very easy. I have here a 1 millimeter gap left and right, which is rather small. So it's based on the type of threading you want, a more like a tight mechanical threading, then it can be small. If you want to have a more looser, bigger threading, then we need to have more spacing. So I will turn this one off, go to this folder, I turn the visibility of this folder on, and turn everything off that I do not need to see. Here, my sketch side profile, I really need to see. Very good. And then I zoom in now where I would like the threading to be modeled into. I go to sketch and I want the threading not directly start at the bottom. So I will zoom in a little bit more and draw one line, another line, and another line. These lines to each other should be 90 degrees. And then one angled line to a vertical line, 135 degrees. Very good. And we can also specify where the threading, for example, should start. Then I zoom out a little bit, exit the sketch. Select one triangle, select the axis line. I will turn off also the section cut. And here comes now the really interesting method to create the threading. I will start the revolve command, 360 degrees, that is okay. And here now I move this up 3 millimeters. And basically with the vertical movement and also the rotation amount, I can specify the gap. I will make this gap a little bit bigger so I can kind of create a pressure lock. Perfect. So this is actually with 400 degree rotation, creating also a nice overlap. That's very good. So this body I hide for the moment, and then I will select the opposite part again, go to here, and do exactly the same steps. Very good. So this I will move actually out, and this goes into the cap folder. And then when I go back to building parts, here is the threading for the bottle. And I will move this out to there. Very good. Okay. This one actually came with it. I moved this back into the cap folder. And let's actually finish the cap part. This face is perpendicular to this face. So we'd like to rotate this. Very easy. Select the face, go to move rotate, move the widget to then edge, and then we just rotate this 45 degrees. Select nothing. And then here we do the same trick. Because of the line, so the edge, it actually finds orientation and perfectly puts them or rotates them. Then union, very good. Let's make this a little bit less tight. So 0.4 millimeters for that rounding, and then 0.2 for those edges. Very good. So the cap then basically actually is done. Here I will do now the same. I will, before however I join this, I will rotate this over and then do the same here. There we are, 0.4. And then this edge and this edge, we fill it with 0.2. Very nice. And I actually would like to have a copy of this. So double tap, here's a little trick. Hit the copy button, hit the translation, let's say we move it up, but by 0 millimeters, press enter, and you see we have a copy. So this threading, I can now add to this bottle. So these two, union. And then these two, I can union. So then this way you see we added actually the threading afterwards very easily because we made two copies. We didn't have to model it twice. We simply glued one to one part and the other one to the other part. We can give this a new name, bottle one, and here, this is the second bottle. Very good. And then when we take a look at these parts, we can just turn on and off how the cap works and the with the bottle. Last pieces, before we go into the visualization, let's add some last minute details. So this edge should be filleted, this edge should be filleted, and this edge should be filleted too. Very good. This gives then a really nice final detail, and you can see the material separation much nicer. Before we can bring everything into the visualization tool, we want to set up our scene correctly. We have bottle one and we have cap. Let's rename this one cap one. And then here is bottle two. So this bottle body, I will move over by 90 millimeters. And then I will select the cap one, go to move, rotate, copy, and then actually make a complete copy of everything, also by 90 millimeters. And then this I will rename into cap two. So this way you have then the ability to just prepare and sort your scene in a much more logical and easier way, as you can see. Very good. Good.